Hello viewers, welcome to Hi-Tech Learner. In today's session, we will see what is computer and computer system. So let's start our today's class. Viewers, as we know, computer is most programmable machine, which follows each and every instruction given by the user. Yes? So, as you know, computer is one of the electronic machine which follows an instruction given by the user. There is two main principal characteristics of a computer which always followed by the CPU. First, it responds to the specific set of instruction which is given by the human in the well-defined manner. For example, when you call a CPU to press enter, it follows same. There are so many pre-executed, pre-recorded list of instruction which CPU follows, like opening of a file, closing, shut down your CPU, etc. So this type of instruction followed by the CPU. Computer system is mix of three units. Well, we see this with the help of diagram. As you can see in the diagram, CPU is our processing unit. First, we have input device, which gives the input to the CPU for processing. After processing each and every data, CPU sends the data to our output device. With the help of output device, we can see the data over the screen. Let's see the inbuilt processing of the CPU in detail. There are three main components of the CPU. As you know, CPU called as central processing unit, which process each and every data sent by the user. When data has been sent by using input device to the computer, it first taken by the control unit as a signal for processing. For example, while entering a data with the help of keyboard. So when we enter a data with the help of keyboard, it first taken by the central processing unit, and for output also we are taking the help of control unit. Then we have arithmetical logical unit. When user is giving any mathematical calculation to the CPU, it is performed by the arithmetical logical unit. For example, you have to do the billions of a calculation of the billions of numbers. It is done by using this arithmetical logical unit only. When central unit takes the data and it passes to the arithmetical logical unit for the mathematical calculation. After all the data has been processed, our data has been stored inside the memory unit. There are internal memory, which is known as primary memory or main memory, where data has been stored permanently inside the CPU. Like your file, images you are storing inside the mobile data memory. Same way, CPU is also having a permanent memory, that is main memory. We'll see more components inside the CPU. When central processing unit and arithmetical unit is doing some processing part, there are a temporary data which travels inside the CPU. To store that temporary data, we have to take a help of registers. Register is a special area where our data has been stored for a temporary period of a time for processing purpose. When all the processing has been completed, then that data will be erased from the registers, and again it will be free from the storing another data for a temporary period of a time. When this processing has been done, the our original data has been transferred to the main memory, and main memory has having a some addresses, that is location, to store our data permanently inside the main memory. Address is like our house address only, home address only, where we find a location of a particular friend's house, our house. Like that, address is also having a particular location where we can find our data easily. Like your C drive, E drive, you can find your files. It is only called as address. Next part is based on input device and output device, which helps us for a completion of this process. We will see in the next part how this input device works, and then processing and the output device. So here, viewers, will complete our today's session. Please like, share and subscribe my channel, and press the bell icon for more videos. Thank you.